graduates, parents, board of trustees, faculty, staff, students, and ISA alumni. Welcome to the International School of Aberdeen graduation ceremony for the class of 2016. I'd like to say a special welcome to all our former students and graduates. It's great to see you here. I'm glad you could join us today. To the class of 2016, you will soon be graduates rather than graduating seniors. This will commence you on your journey through life. Thus why graduation is also called commencement. This is a journey where you're lucky to have the love and support of family and friends, such as was displayed last night at your Kaylee. And I understand you had a great time. Must be a great excitement to have those closest to you sharing in this next phase of your life. I know it is also exciting for you to share this day with your classmates. When I had lunch with you in small groups, one of the questions I asked you was what you liked about ISA. You very kindly mentioned your teachers and how you felt they genuinely wanted you to succeed. You also mentioned the ISA family and that you liked the feeling of community here. But ultimately, there was one answer which was so common among all of you, and it's that you like each other. You like your class. Now, it's particularly interesting because you also pointed out you're different from one another. You don't necessarily do everything together. And yet, you as a class have embraced the differences between you. You've been able to enjoy each other for what each of you bring to the whole and enjoy how that forms your class. Whether you were pretending to do work in the uni room or you were actually doing serious service work, you enjoyed each other. And we could tell that by all the laughter. I'm excited about your journey after graduation because I'm confident your attitude of celebrating differences and your unique abilities will serve you well in life. You have the ability to positively influence those around you with your tolerance, the ability to influence others with your acceptance of different cultures and beliefs, the ability to make things better for you and for others through service, and the ability to enjoy others for who they are, for being themselves, and for what they bring to the whole. I'm confident that these are just some of the things that you, the class of 2016, will contribute to our world. It's time to commence. Congratulations. I hope you thoroughly enjoy your graduation day. Each year, the Outstanding Student Award is presented at the Awards Assembly to a graduating senior who has established an outstanding academic record, participated broadly in the school community, and embodies the school's values. It gives me great pleasure to introduce this year's outstanding student, Ellen Howell.
Dear fellow graduates, parents, teachers, family, and staff, this day has been approaching for a very long time, yet it still feels surprising to be standing here in front of you all today. It is hard to describe the mixed feelings of joy and nostalgia that accompany this celebration. Today marks the day that we finally graduate from high school, but it also marks the day that many of us will be saying goodbye to each other for the very last time. In the 5 years that I have attended ISA, I have seen many people join and leave the ISA community. Today we are not just celebrating the graduation of the students that are sitting here, but also the graduation of all the students that have ever been a part of our class, whether they are sitting in the audience or elsewhere. I have no doubt in my mind that our class will be remembered long after we graduate from ISA. Not just because of the number of students that missed the deadlines for their extended essays, or the broken couch in the uni room, but because of the invaluable experiences that we've shared together as a class. Personally, I know that I will never forget waking up on the roof of a house in Morocco to the sounds of shores playing the tin whistle, or playing tall illustrations in the uni room. I am sure that years from now, we will all remember watching Umi's and Ghetto's heartwarming video where they show the little things that we do under pressure. If not, we will definitely remember the uncomfortable experience of ghetto interrogating us for it. Many of us will also remember singing World War I songs on the bus trip to Belgium, or turning the high school hallway into a beach with an inflatable pool on our last day of senior year. Together as a class, we've overcome many challenges, from hiking in the Atlas Mountains of Morocco, learning how to play batonk in France, or learning how to dance flamenco in Spain. But let's be honest, the most difficult challenge we've gone through together, as a class, has been overcoming the IB, right here in this building. We are very fortunate going to ISA, to be a part of such a nurturing and caring learning environment, where the teachers and staff are always willing to take the time to personally help students. I know that I won't forget eating donuts in early morning math classes, listening to podcasts about black holes and coloring relativity cartoons in physics, having fierce debates in French class, or hearing an endless supply of science jokes and puns in chemistry class, even if I didn't get them all. And although I haven't experienced them, I hear the weekly ESS parties get pretty crazy, and that true artistic talents have been discovered while modeling clay figures in history class. Ultimately, it is only with the dedication and ingenuity of all of our teachers and the support from all the members of the ISA community that we have accomplished so much in our time here. I think it is important to stop for a moment to appreciate and recognize all of the people, whether they be brothers, sisters, parents, teachers, staff, and anybody else, whoever they may be, who has helped us to reach this moment. But the truth is that while we have accomplished a lot in our time here, there will be many more obstacles to come for us in the future. After today, many of us will be in different parts of the world, going on to further education or volunteering. Some of us will be traveling to different places in the UK. Others will be going to the United States, Canada, Spain, France, or even Honduras. But no matter where we go, we will have to make difficult decisions about what we want to do, and even more importantly, who we want to be. The French historian Jacques Barzan once stated, "A culture may be conceived as a network of beliefs and purposes in which any string pulls and is pulled by the others, thus perpetually changing the configuration of the whole." Many of you, especially my peers sitting beside me, will recognize this metaphor. Personally, I know that it has been irrecoverably branded into my brain after the arduous March Madness speech and debate tournament. At the time, we used it to debate how artists have made contributions to or altered society or the configuration of the whole. At this point, all of us have the ability and the potential to have an impact on society, whether it be as an artist, a scientist, an engineer, a historian, anything else that we can possibly imagine. Our teachers and parents have helped us to get this far, but now it is our turn to take initiative and try to make a positive impact in any way that we can. Because as the English philosopher Herbert Spencer once said, the great aim of education is not knowledge, but action. Everybody has to start somewhere. And for the ISA class of 2016, graduating today represents the beginning of a journey, not the end of one.
On the way, on the way, on the way. the Jim Burns Senior Service Award. This award is named after Jim Burns. Jim was the father of Craig Burns, who is now our head custodian. Mr. Burns' dedication and service during his long employment at ISA was exemplary. As stated in the school's educational philosophy, a well-rounded education should provide meaningful opportunities for students to become active, positive members of the community. The recipient of this award has demonstrated outstanding service to the school and community. They have taken on service willingly and with a positive attitude. It is our privilege to announce that this year's recipient of the Jim Burns Senior Service Award is Keegan Ill. European Council of International Schools Award for International Understanding. This award goes to a student who is a good representative of his or her country with a positive attitude towards life and the cultures of others. They are able to converse in at least two languages and are a contributing force in the life of the school with the ability to bring differing people together into a sense of community, thus furthering the cause of international understanding. It is an honor to present the ECIS Award for International Understanding to this year's deserving recipient, Nalfal Gidiana. English and history teachers, is this year's commencement speaker. In addition to her teaching, she is also our environmental club advisor. She had the pleasure of teaching some of this year's grads in middle school, as well as during their IB years. The students know that Mrs. Gary will support them however she can, and that she has enjoyed teaching them throughout their years here. They have selected her to give this year's address. It is now my pleasure to introduce this year's commencement speaker, Val Gary.
Graduates, I would like to thank you for the opportunity to speak today. Graduates, I'm truly touched that you wish to share your special day with me. Although I will admit that as I contemplated the task you had given me, I did wonder if there was not some small measure of retribution for all the assignments I have given you over the years. Nonetheless, the opportunity to speak with you one more time was, of course, too special to pass up. However, this excitement was marked with, I admit, a little fear, which was, I reflected, perhaps akin to how you are feeling right now as you stand at these crossroads in your life. Behind you lies the certainties of your family with its first-class food, laundry, and chauffeur service. And also, there are the friendships you have made and the life you know at ISA. But in front of you lies exciting possibilities of new friends, new places, new opportunities. Graduation is perhaps, however, a time to take a moment to reflect on the past. Graduates, as you, despite perhaps a little nervousness, look eagerly forward to the new stage in your life, I know as a mother who has watched two of my own children go off to university, your parents are also thinking of all the stages that have gone before and the excitement, tinged with a little trepidation, that they had for you then. Your first step, your first tooth, your first school trip, and many other memories that have marked stages in your childhood and brought you to today. Also, parents, you are possibly reflecting on how the relationship between you and your child has grown and changed, as they move through these stages of life. And perhaps your children are approaching a time when they would agree with the American author Mark Twain, who is humorously supposed to have said, "When I was a boy of 14, my father was so ignorant, I could hardly stand to have the old man around. But when I got to be 21, I was astonished at how much he had learned in 7 years. Graduates, for your teachers too, this moment is bittersweet. We are eager to see you take up the challenges we have worked hard to help prepare you for, but we too remember many stages along the way. Believe it or not, I can remember a time when many of you were shorter than me. And before you helped turn my hair this gorgeous shade of platinum blonde. Together, we have climbed mountains, literally at Outward Bound during an outdoor week in middle school, and metaphorically during the last 2 years of IB history. There, we wrestled with some of the big questions of 20th century history and learned that despite sounding so strange to anyone who was not in history class, that there are times when it is useful to keep Hitler in the back of your mind. Memorably too, I've also tried to instill in some of you some basic principles of childcare. When in your 8th grade health class, some of you participated in the flower baby simulation. There you had to care for a 4 kilogram sack of flour for a week. Easy, you'd think. But I recall one of these babies taking an unfortunate tumble down a rather long stairwell. I'll say no more. Also, I have shared in some of your sporting endeavors. For example, 2 years ago with a near triumph for the boys in Barcelona, and more recently with a nail-biting win for the girls in London. So after all that time spent together, and as we stand at this crossroads in your life, looking fondly back to the past, but excitedly and perhaps a little nervously to the future, what, I asked myself, should I say to you? Seeking inspiration, yes, I admit it, I Googled graduation speech. I can't say that the 9,230,000 results in 0.46 seconds was of much help. Truthfully, I think I felt even more nervous than before, because apparently I'm supposed to offer life advice, words of wisdom, and ideas on being successful and happy. And more importantly, do it in 10 minutes or less. So no pressure. Now the verb Google has been firmly added to our modern vocabulary, but you might be surprised to hear that it's not a new word. Well, at least not here in Scotland. In the Scots language, the word Google means to deceive or hoodwink. So as a native Scot, I'm immediately suspicious of Googling. But here's some life advice. The advice of experts is not always sound. For example, in 1977, the president of the Digital Equipment Corporation confidently advised there is no reason for any individual to have a computer in their own home. Look how useful that piece of advice turned out to be. Thus, I decided that relying on so-called experts was not wise, and so returned somewhat worriedly to my starting place, my fear at having to give this speech. But this led me to reflect on how at important moments in life, fear, or at least nervousness, is often a component. Fear is not real, but it is a result of our own thoughts. Danger now, that's real, but fear only exists in our minds. So fear is a choice. Thus what defines us is not fear, but how we choose to face it. Life doesn't usually follow the plans we lay out for ourselves. There will be highs and lows, the difficult and the easy, and plenty of places to be scared in between. Eddie Rickenbacker, a World War I fighter pilot, stated that courage is doing what you're afraid to do. There can be no courage unless you're scared. Most of us don't think of ourselves as courageous, but courage comes in many shapes and sizes. As one of my favorite literary characters, Atticus Finch, in the novel To Kill a Mockingbird argued, courage is not a man with a gun in his hand. Hence, courage isn't always about grand moments, as we sometimes see depicted in Hollywood. Some such moments don't all happen on battlefields. Rather, they happen in your heart. And most of us will be asked to find courage in hundreds of different ways and in hundreds of small moments in our lives. As the basketball coach John Wooden said, success is never final, failure is never fatal. It's courage that counts. So of the different kinds of courage, what courage would I ask of you? Firstly, have the courage to stand up for what you believe. Edmund Burke, an English philosopher, said, "All that is necessary for the triumph of evil is that good men do nothing." And this has too often been true in history. Thus, make sure you know what you believe. Think it through. Are you doing this because it's for a good cause? Are you doing this simply because everyone else is? Are you well informed? In the realm of morality and ethics, with respect to good and evil, right and wrong, there are principles and ideals that instruct and endure. Seek these out and commit to them. In order for others to believe in what you have to say, do not think negatively. If you want to stand up for a good cause, you need to believe that you can make a difference. Now I know that many of you have begun to explore the things you believe in: gender equality, the environment, and in many political discussions I've had with some of you. According to President Obama, the world today has a cascade of challenges in it. We can all think of many: refugee issues, global warming, religious intolerance, poverty. I could go on. But it is without doubt a world which needs intelligent, thoughtful people who are willing to take a stand for what's right. I encourage you to be one of these people. So, what other forms of courage might serve on this journey? My next suggestion is not glamorous, but it is essential, I believe, for success. Have the courage to work hard. Your dreams and ambitions will not become reality through magic. They will take hard work and perseverance. Challenges are things that are impossible to avoid, but the question is, just how hard are you willing to work to overcome them? Will you fold when the going gets tough, or will you stick and see it through? In the case of Bill Gates, yes, he had access to a computer, but then he logged 10,000 hours of programming time. For the Beatles, it was 1,200 small one-hour shows that got them ready for superstardom. And Winston Churchill, one of the 20th century's greatest orators, is known to have practiced his speeches compulsively. So the good news then is that you are not a hostage to some talent you may or may not have been born with. Rather, all you need is the courage to work hard, and then you can make of yourself what you will. To paraphrase Thomas Jefferson, I'm a great believer in luck, and the harder I work, the luckier I get. Finally, but by no means least, have the courage to be kind. Think, speak, and act with kindness. Now you'd think being kind would be easy, but it turns out it's not. It's pretty easy to be kind to puppies and babies, but much more difficult to be kind to, well, just about everyone else. But if you think for a moment, everyone here can probably remember the people who were kind to them. As the American poet Maya Angelou said, "I've learned that people will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel." So it's not all about chasing after individual success. Our communities and societies do well when we take care of each other. We actually benefit from giving support more than receiving it. And in return, we are more likely to get support when we need it. The ISA community is known for its kindness, and I have seen quite a few members of this graduating class particularly exemplify a caring spirit. But I encourage all of you as you venture forth, remember to have the courage to be kind whenever and wherever you can. It will cost you nothing, and I guarantee that you will get so much back. Well, I'm sure that my 10 minutes is up, and you have listened to me for long enough. From thinking about my fear in giving this speech, it seems I might indeed have managed to give you some advice. However, although the words and encouragement of others can be immensely helpful throughout life, ultimately, summoning up the courage to stand up for what you believe, to work hard, and to be kind to others will require you to listen to your own inner voice, much more than the voices of others. I wish each and every one of you the very best in your bright future. And as the ever-changing world swirls around you, remember to have courage in whatever form that might be necessary, quiet or loud, big or small. And if you would indulge me one last time, I'd like to borrow some words from the character Benjamin Button when he says, "There are no rules to this thing. We can make the best or the worst of it. I hope you make the best of it. I hope you see things that startle you. I hope you feel things you never felt before. I hope you meet people of a different point of view. I hope you live a life you can be proud of. Thank you.
Mrs. Carey. It is my honor to verify to the school board that the graduates before you have met the requirements for the awarding of the diploma from the International School of Aberdeen. I am pleased to invite Mr. Eric Nydam, our chairman of the ISA Board of Trustees, to join us on stage in the awarding of the diplomas.
Eric Thompson. Eric has attended ISA for the past 4 years. He would like to thank his grandparents for making the trip over from Newfoundland, and he would like to sincerely apologize to anyone who has had to listen to him complain about the IB for the last 2 years. Eric will attend the University of British Columbia in Vancouver. Ryan Slade. Ryan has been at ISA for 6 years and has enjoyed his time attending this school. He would like to thank his parents for their support and Fernando and Victor for always being there. Okay. Victoria for always being there. He plans to attend York St. John's University to study TESOL and Spanish. Joshua Rosano. Josh has attended ISA for 3 years and would like to thank his family who came all the way from Houston. He will attend Baylor University, but will always remember the memories made with his ISA peers. Fernando Perez. Fernando has been at ISA since last year and would like to acknowledge his dad for sharing this Scottish experience with him. Fernando will continue his studies in economics in the future. He'd also like to thank his family for coming all the way to Aberdeen for his graduation. Gracias, tía. Gabriella Duncan. Gabriella has attended ISA since seventh grade. She would like to thank her teachers and family for their unconditional support, and her mom and dad for tolerating her throughout the IB program. And of course, a shout out to the chums. To her sister and best friend, Antonia, thank you for the laughter when she needed it most. She feels eternally grateful for having a sister like her. Thank you, ISA, for 6 incredible years.
Gillian Marwood. Gillian would like to thank her family and friends, and she would especially like to thank her best friends and buddies and all the good times she's had here. Lauren DeGraw. Lauren has been at ISA since first grade. She would like to thank all her friends for her amazing memories and a shout out to the chums. She would also like to thank her family for their continuous support and the amazing teachers along the way. Lauren will hopefully study psychology and education at the University of York. Christian Bond. After 2 years with the IB, Christian can finally sleep safely with no memories. He wishes to say thank you to his parents for the moral support and constant flow of snacks from packed lunches. They were real lifesavers. Christian would also like to thank Mr. Hollis for teaching him how Shakespeare relates to the real world, which is why what is fair is foul and foul is fair seems so much more reasonable with IB context. Finley Vandervossen. Finley has attended ISA for 5 years and would like to take the opportunity to thank his teachers, his good friends, Haya, and of course his parents. Victor Ojabo. Having been at ISA for almost a decade, Victor has seen many people come and go, but has made many lifelong friends in the process. He would like to thank family and friends for being there for him throughout his school time. Specifically, he would like to thank his mom and dad. His dad for always being a great role model and giving him helpful advice, and his mom for feeding him for the last 18 years. Because he doesn't know how he will feed himself at university. Cole Roberts. Cole moved to Aberdeen in the seventh grade and has enjoyed the last 6 years at ISA. He would like to thank his parents for their continuous support and his siblings for helping him survive that support. He would also like to thank his Nana and his aunt and uncle for flying all this way. Cole plans to study industrial distribution at Texas A&M. Also, shout out to the squad for sticking with Cole. Dominic Burns. Dominic has attended ISA for 3 years, Throughout this time, he has improved educationally and in the field of sport. Dominique would like to thank his family and friends for supporting the IB process. Nafal Andika Udiana. Nafal has been a student at ISA since August 2014 and thoroughly enjoyed every minute of it. He would like to thank his parents who have had to stand him for the last 17 years and his IB teachers for guiding him through the program for the last 2 years. Nafal hopes to study government and economics at the London School of Economics and hopes to keep in touch with his classmates wherever they go. Imogen Moore. Imi would like to thank her parents and her sister for all the support and encouragement. She would also like to thank Karen for all the help and support. She will be attending university in London. She is taking this as her cue to skidoo and to get the hecky heck out of here. Jordan Rivera. Jordan will be attending university in London. She would like to thank her parents and friends for surrounding her with constant love, support, and filling her life with fulfilling memories and happiness. You guys are so important to her. Emily Kuipers. Emily has lived in Aberdeen since the year 2000, joined ISA in the fourth grade, and can't wait to escape and study psychology. She would like to thank her dad for being calm during this time and her mom for stressing for Emily in her place. Celia Morgan. Celia hopes to be studying physics next year and would like to thank her family for their support over the last 2 years. But still, she is looking forward to attending Georgia Tech in the fall. She would like to thank her parents, teachers, friends, and French class. It's been great. Beatrice Acevedo. Bea has been attending ISA for 8 years and is leaving a basketball championship in her last year. She wants to thank her parents for being there even when the maths got hard. Shout out to French class for being les plus bons. Haya Geyer. Haya will always remember the pride of being at ISA the longest, surpassing Lauren by a whopping 7 days. Other fond memories will be of her French classes and unproductive study halls in the senior sanctuary. She would like to thank her friends, especially Loki and Finley, as well as her family and her grandparents, but wishes Aika could have been here for her senior year. Adele Green Armitage. Adele has been at ISA since eighth grade. She has especially enjoyed the school trips with the volleyball team and the Morocco trip. She hopes to study biological sciences in the UK. She would like to thank her mom and dad for their support, and a special shout out to her friends Simone and Aika, and others who have left, who sadly couldn't graduate at ISA with their class. Emer Winifred O'Connell. Emer has attended ISA for a collective 5.5 years. She wants to thank her friends, parents, and brother for their constant support and guidance. Special thanks to the Lady Bison B-Ball Champs and Mr. Gary for putting her back in after she almost fouled out in the first quarter. Thanks, Juliet and the class of 2016 for the fun, frivolity, and friendship. And finally, farewell study hall bathroom. You will be missed, but Moja, you will not. Juliet Smith. Juliet has attended ISA for the past 3 years. She would like to thank her family, especially her mom, for supporting her. She would also like to thank the basketball team and Coach Gary, who pretended not to worry during halftime at the final. Lastly, Juliet would like to thank Emer for breaking couches, but not friendships. Leah Wisson. Leah has been at ISA since 10th grade. She would like to thank her parents for always supporting her and to tell her brother that he will always be her favorite loser. She would also like to thank the IB program for teaching her the art of taking the perfect nap. Leah will attend the University of Colorado at Boulder, let's go Buffs, and to all her classmates and friends, come visit her in Boulder. Sender Svendheim. Sender has attended ISA for the past 2 years. He would like to thank his uncle for the opportunity to stay with him in Aberdeen and the support he has received. Next year, Sender will hope to be attending the University of Edinburgh studying economics. Austin Weisenfelder. Austin. Austin has attended ISA for the past 3 years, having moved here from Alaska for the weather. He's our resident nerd, and would like to thank his teachers and his parents for their patience and attention. He will be attending the University of Illinois, Urbana-Champaign next year. James Appleby. James has been at ISA since ninth grade. He would like to thank his parents for giving him the opportunity to study at ISA. While he will miss his family and great people at ISA who have made the experience enjoyable and undoubtedly worthwhile, he is also looking ahead to university life. Lewis Craig. Lewis has attended ISA for the past 3 years. Lewis would like to thank his parents for their support and also thank his friends for all the fond memories. Lewis will hopefully be attending the University of Aberdeen. Joshua Levalion. Joshua would like to thank his family and friends, as well as all the people that came today for their support. Shores Lyle. Shores has been at ISA since seventh grade and loved every minute of it. He would like to thank his mom, dad, and sisters for their constant support. He would also like to thank the Duke of Edinburgh group for all the memories. He plans to study history at the University of St. Andrews. Ihi Ibo Dage. Ihi wishes to thank the peeps at ISA for the fabulous memories. She wants to thank God, her parents, and her teachers for the much needed tough love and support. She hopes to go and study medicine. Big up to Madame Bonnard, La Classe de Francaise. C'est une de pas une catastrophe. Shout out to Ghetto for being a winner. To siblings, hard work is a major key. I'm out. Bless up. Zainab Yamusa. Ghetto would like to thank the IB for reminding her that diamonds really are made under pressure and for the memories and scars that will always remain with her. Big up to God for keeping her going, Dr. Carmichael, because he asked for it. To Ihi, because she will always be a winner in her eyes, and to Aberdeen for being the only country she knows that can snow and be sunny on the same day. P.S. Thanks, Mom, for letting me mess up your dining table. although I know you'll miss my sick tunes. Not to cry. P.P.S. Leave my room ubede. Leave it. P.P.P.S. Aberdeen is not a country. If you got it, congrats. If you didn't, school starts in August. Keegan Ill. Keegan has been at ISA since he was 12 and would like to thank his peers who are graduating with him today and his family for their constant support. Peter Keyes. Peter moved to ISA in August 2014 and has enjoyed making new friends in the little time his teachers allowed him to socialize. He would like to thank his family and teachers for their continued support throughout IB and is looking forward to a volunteer year teaching in Honduras. Owen Plummer. Owen has been at ISA for 5 years and has thoroughly enjoyed his time here. He has particularly enjoyed his economics class and hopes to study it at the University of Warwick. His favorite memories include his Duke of Edinburgh hike and winning the badminton tournament in 10th grade. He would like to thank his family very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present the graduated class of 2016.